diagnosed at a very young age with stage 4 cervical cancer. I started attending Dr. Mancini's seminars. His information that he was teaching really resonated with me.
Over 80% of our healthcare challenges are lifestyle choices.
I knew that I could use his information to help self-heal. Thank you, Dr. Mancini, for being a beacon of hope for me and now millions of others.
Well, that was Dr. Fabrizio Mancini, who has been pivotal in transforming lives of thousands of people. He's an internationally acclaimed inspirational speaker. He's an author. He's an educator. He's a philanthropist. And he's the president of Parker University in Dallas, Texas. And he has written a groundbreaking new book called The Power of Self-Healing: Unlock Your Natural Healing Potential in 21 Days. So please welcome a really dear and personal friend of mine, Dr. Fabrizio Mancini. You know, people ask me all the time, they say, well, you know, Dr. Phil, who takes care of you? And I say, well, first Robin, she's the one that gets me by the ear and straightens me out. But I met you 14 years ago, right?
Yes.
And I had never used a chiropractor before. And in generations before, chiropractor has been criticized a lot. It hasn't had a great reputation. But I was open to it because when I was practicing and I worked with a lot of orthopedic surgeons, a key member of their treatment team was a properly trained chiropractor. And so when I started having problems, you did not treat my back. You treated me. You really got into what you call the three parts right. of this that are important. And it's a very holistic sort of thing. You can't have a one-legged stool. You can't have a two-legged stool. And you say there's physical self-healing, emotional self-healing, and spiritual self-healing. Talk about what you mean.
Well, the first thing to recognize is that our bodies are self-healing and self-regulating. So that means that we're already born to heal naturally. Number two is that I learned that the master system is the controlling system of the body. It supports all the cells, all the organs. So the physical component is what most of us are used to, you know. Move your body, exercise regularly, make sure that our body has an ability to move. Movement is life. We have to make better choices, you know. Almost over 80% of the diseases that we have today are made because of the choices we make on a physical plane. And that's why for me in chiropractic, the one thing that it taught me, more important than anything, is that we see patients as well. That means I see you as a well individual. I don't see you as a sick individual. My job is to try to figure out any possible way naturally to facilitate that self-healing inside of yourself and address the cause of the problem, not just manage symptoms.
Did you hear he said I was well, Robin? Said I'm
yes.
a well individual?
Yes, because you know. Of him.
Okay, yeah, right. When I was in Dallas, I got chiropractic treatments from you like 2-3 times a week.
Right.
And now I'm in L.A. The first thing I did was talk to Dr. Mancini, found one of the graduates from Parker University, who's Dr. DeFazio, sitting right here, Patrick DeFazio. And we've seen each other for 10 years?
10 years
at least
now.
Twice a week,
yes,
right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. What do people not understand about this wellness business? Because you guys really approach this in a holistic way, and you do with me.
From chiropractic perspective, we look at the body as a whole, and we work to allow the body to restore itself to normal function. So what we do is help the body release its own innate power to heal itself.
Look, I want to put some of this into play here because I want to add somebody to the conversation. Now, Joe was only 5 years old when his entire life dramatically changed. And now, 40 years later, he still feels trapped in an emotional nightmare. You're going to really relate to this. Take a look.
When I was 5 years old, the drunk driver ran a red light. She was clocked at 120 miles per hour, and she crashed into my family's car. My sister Maria, who was 11, was thrown from the back seat through the windshield. I was thrown out of the car and into the woods. The tragedy really was my dad and my sister both passed away. After the accident, we were at the hospital. I woke up in a bed and my mom was sitting next to me. And I said to her, I can't feel my legs. Just as I said that, a doctor walked in and said, yes, son, you're paralyzed, and you're never going to walk again. When I heard the words, you're scared. You're basically just terrified because you don't know what your life is going to be like now. I was a prisoner in my own body. When we entered court with Andrea, the drunk driver, Andrea got away with everything. She got no